examples for all his sandhis, right? I have it in my book. I wrote down examples for you, but I don't want to give it today because of the nature of the program going on in the ashram. And I have to rush upstairs to give a talk to the new parent. Today, all the new students who come into the Vidyalaya, maybe 150 parents will be there. So I have to address them. So I want to give you something else today. And I know how long you just take to write, so by the time you don't write, and I go, don't talk and come back, you know. All right, so before I write on the board, let us practice Mati. Mati, see in your book, that was the last one we declension we did, right? Mati, intelligence, intellect, like that. Mati. Understanding, all of these things. Consideration. Mati is a wide use in Sanskrit, right? Now, say it after me. Look, I hope you find your card. You're supposed to have a card. That is the easiest way. So you could walk about with your card here and there. Matihi?
Matihi.
Matihi?
Matihi.
No, short E. Matihi?
Matihi.
Mati?
Mati.
Matayaha?
Matayaha.
Matim?
Matim.
Mati?
Mati.
Matihi?
Matihi.
Mati. Matya, yes, you see, now third changes. Matya?
Matya.
Matibhyam? Matibhi.
Matibhi.
Matye?
Matye.
Or Mataye also, it's a double, right? Matye or Mataye?
Matye, Mataye.
Matibhyam? Matibhyaha. Matehe? Matyaha. Matibhyam? Matibhyaha. Matehe? Matyaha. Matyoho. Matinam. You see, it becomes long there, right? And that's 6th case plural. Matyam. Matau. Matyoho. Matishu.
Matishu.
Hey Mate.
Hey
Mate. Hey Mati.
Hey
Mati. Hey Matayaha.
Hey Matayaha.
Okay, now
that was ending in short E. Right? E. Now I want to give you long E. Like that will be now the example is Nadi. Nadi means a river. And in we were doing short E, we did Hari for masculine and Mati for feminine. Neuter, fewer there, let us leave that for the time being. Not so popular. Use your memory in your hard drive for that to be popular, right? Use the hard drive space for what popular. So, neuter, short E, is it there? We'll come back to it. I'm arguing on. We'll come to that. But now we jump to long E. Long E, masculine, you're lucky. Not there. Long E, masculine, not there. Just like long, like ah. Masculine was not there, remember? So theta was here, there. So here, long E, you say, but after masculine, now feminine.
Oh,
too many. So many are there. Alright. So the example I'm going to give you now is Nadi. Nadi means a river. Right. That means feminine noun ending in? E. When you write down. Oops.
Let me just see this with them. Okay, now stop writing. Say it after me, then you will write when I leave here now. So now you see this ending E, and it's feminine, right? Feminine, ending E. So it's almost like it's mati, which we just did. But because it's ending in long, everywhere it will be, wherever you see, long, 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 see? It will come long every time. And the rest of them resemble mati very much. So now say it after me. Nadi.
Nadi.
Nadyau.
Nadyau.
Nadyaha.
Nadyaha.
Nadim.
Nadim.
Nadyau.
Nadyau.
And see, just like mati here. Nadihi.
Nadihi.
Nadya.
Nadya.
Nadibhyam.
Nadibhyam.
Nadibhihi.
Nadibhihi.
Nadye.
Nadye.
Nadibhyam.
Nadibhyam.
Nadibhyaha.
Nadibhyaha.
Nadyaha.
Nadyaha.
Nadibhyam.
Nadibhyam.
Nadibhyaha.
Nadibhyaha.
Nadyaha.
Nadyaha.
Nadyoho.
Nadyoho.
Nadinam.
Nadinam.
Nadyam.
Nadyam.
Nadyoho.
Nadyoho.
Nadishu.
Nadishu.
Hey, Nadi. You have to be very careful here. See, this is the only place, even though this ending in long, you see what I mean here? And it mati, even though it was short E, over here had become long. You remember that? Over there and there. So sometimes you have a little variation. That is to keep you awake. Hey, Nadi.
Hey, Nadi.
Anadyo.
Anadyo. Yeah. Follows the first case.
Hey, Nadi.
Hey, Nadi.
Hey, Nadyo.
Hey,
now, it is very common. Yeah. Many, many nouns in Sanskrit that end with a long E. Like Nari, Nagari, like that. Nari is woman. So these are common nouns. Now I'll just leave a Kalkayaji till I come back, till I give you talk upstairs and come back. She'll write a list here of all nouns ending in E. Right? So they will all be declined just like Nadi. I'll be back soon. Okay. Happy writing.
Cindy.
If you'd like, we can just say the words so that you can also be certain that you're saying them, writing them correctly, right? Is that Nagari?
Nagari.
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 Right? So sometimes we also say Nagar, that also means like a town. So this is feminine version of that word. Then Dhatri.
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 Good. Nurse. Prithvi.
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 Earth. Then Vani.
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 Right. So Vani.
Vani.
So also you'll see it as another name for Mother Saraswati sometimes because she's the goddess of speech, so she'll also be called that. Then Rani.
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 Then Simhi.
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 Janani.
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 Jai.
Then Nari.
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 Then there's a Patni.
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 Right? There's a half ta and then na. Then Bhagini.
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 The sister. Then Grihini.
Grihini.
R. Right? So Grihini. Then Sharbari.
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 It's night. Rani. This one is someone was asking this question. I'll just write it on the board. This is like Nya in Nyana. Okay. This one is Ja. So it's a conjunct. So that's why if you see in the translation, say you write this. You have to write. See? This conjunct is this. If you technically you want to expand it, it's this one is.
Yes? Questions? Swamiji will come just now. He just has to give the address upstairs for the convocation ceremony. Right? So, use the pointer. Nadi.
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 Nadyo.
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 So we know what this conjunct is? Dya, dya. So it's the and ya, right? And it's alpa prana, it's a small the, not the. Okay? So it's not this the. It's the other the, which I don't have on the board. To, but you all know it, so. Okay. Nadi nadyau.
Nadi nadyau.
Nadyaha.
Nadyaha.
Nadi nadyau nadyaha.
Nadi nadyau nadyaha.
Nadim nadyau nadihi.
Nadim nadyau nadihi.
Nadim nadyau nadihi.
Nadim nadyau nadihi.
Nadya Nadi Bhyam Nadi Bihi.
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 Nadye Nadi Bhyam Nadi Bhyaha.
Nadye Nadi Bhyam Nadi Bhyaha.
Nadye Nadi Bhyam Nadi Bhyaha. Nadyaha nadibhyam nadibhyaha.
Nadyaha nadibhyam nadibhyaha.
Nadyaha nadibhyam nadibhyaha.
Nadyaha nadibhyam nadibhyaha.
Then nadyaha nadyoho nadina.
Nadyaha nadyoho nadina.
Nadyaha nadyoho nadina. Nadyam, nadyoho, nadishu.
Nadyam, nadyoho, nadishu.
Nadyam, nadyoho, nadishu.
Nadyam, nadyoho, nadishu.
Hey, Nadi.
Hey, Nadi.
Hey, Nadi.
Hey, Nadi.
Hey, Nadyau.
Hey, Nadyau.
Hey, Nadyau.
Hey, Nadyau.
Hey, Nadyah.
Hey, Nadyah.
Hey, Nadyah.
Okay.
If I can just give a tip, is to say these over and over again, because what will happen is a lot of times you won't, the whole chart won't come to your mind, or you know, because you have so many different noun forms, and but when you're reading through something, even simple Bhagavad Gita verses, then you'll see that ending and it will trigger that sound in your mind. So even if you see somewhere else, say Prithivyam. Prithivyam comes in some of the chanting, right? So that yam ending, so it should remind us of that sound of nadyam, prithivyam. So then you'll be able to figure out what function it's playing in that sentence. So saying it over and over again, really, really, really important. I avoided it for a long time in the beginning, and then I realized how important it was to understand. So that's very helpful. Even if you go and look in Gita, you'll be able to pick out some of the nouns and know what they're doing, because you'll know the endings. Okay? So it helps a lot. So we'll do it again. Nadi, nadyau, nadyaha.
Nadi, nadyau, nadyaha.
Nadi, nadyau, nadyaha.
Nadi, nadyau, nadyaha.
Nadim, nadyau, nadihi.
Nadim, nadyau, nadihi.
Nadim, nadyau, nadihi.
Nadya
nadi bhyam nadi bhihi.
Nadya nadi bhyam nadi bhihi.
Nadya nadi bhyam nadi bhihi.
Nadya nadi bhyam nadi bhihi.
Nadyai nadi bhyam nadi bhyaha.
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 Nadyah nadi bhyam nadi bhi Nadyah nadi bhyam nadi bhyaha.
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 Nadyah nadyoh nadinam.
Nadyah nadyoh nadinam.
Nadyah nadyoh nadinam.
Nadyah nadyoh nadinam.
Nadyam nadyoh nadishu.
Nadyam nadyoh nadishu.
Nadyam nadyoh nadishu.
Nadyam nadyoh nadishu.
Hey Nadi.
Hey Nadi.
Hey Nadi.
Hey Nadi.
Hey Nadyau.
Hey Nadyau.
Hey Nadyau.
Hey Nadyau.
Hey Nadyah.
Hey Nadyah.
Hey Nadyah.
Hey Nadyah.
Nagari.
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 Dhatri.
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 Prithvi.
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 Varni.
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 Rani.
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 Simhi.
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 So in masculine, that one is?
Simha.
Simha. So then, to make feminine, just, so, and also, Nara is man, and then Nari becomes woman. So, very nice the scheme like that. Okay, then Janani.
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 Everyone knows Janani because in Ramayana, Hanumanji, and Mata Janaki also comes. Oh, that's, she is Janaki because father is King Janak. But Janani also is. Then, Nari.
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 Woman. And Patni.
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 His wife. Then, Bhagini.
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 Sister. Then, Grihini.
Grihini.
Grihi. Gr, gr. Right? Not Gri. Because Gri would be like,
like Sugriva comes Gri like this, but this is Gru, Gru. So this one is not Rahalan, this one is Ru. This is La, Ru. It's the vowel, right? So Grihini.
Grihini.
Grihini. Right, then Sharvari.
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 Nagar Yoho. So this, that second line won't be there. This one, Nad Yoho.
Nad Yoho.
Oh, you want to do Nagar, right? So, oh, I see. Nagar Yoho. Correct. Okay. So, if you'd like, we can go through the cases, or if you have any questions, also you can ask me. So as you know, the cases in Sanskrit, this is 1st through 8th case, they're also known as Vibhaktis. These different cases tell you what is the function of the noun in the sentence, right? So if you have an English sentence, I think Swamiji would have given you the sentence, the dog jumps over the fox. You got that right? So dog is the subject, then the object is the fox, and the action is jumping, okay? So you can take out over. Dog jumps the fox, so that you know the subject is performing the action on this object. Now, this first case is the nominative case, which is the subject case. So whatever our subject is will come in first case, depending on how many. So say you have one dog jumped over the fox, then you would put him in singular. Two dogs jumped over the fox, dual. Three or more dogs jumped over the fox. You don't know how many, right? Then it becomes plural. In the same way, if this is the subject case, then the subject case, if this is the object case, then this tells the number of the object. So say you have one dog, okay? Subject is dog. Then did he jump over one fox, two fox, or any foxes? Good. Saraji is here. They just asked the question. So Saraji, they practiced a few times and they got the vocab also practiced. So Saraji can go from there.
Alright, everybody finished writing?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Alright, I'll take it.
No one more practice before I erase it. Right?
Nadi.
Nadi.
Nadyau.
Nadyau.
Nadyaha.
Nadyaha.
Nadim.
Nadim.
Nadyau.
Nadyau.
Nadihi.
Nadihi.
Nadya.
Nadya.
Nadibhyam.
Nadibhyam.
Nadibhihi.
Nadibhihi.
Nadyai.
Nadyai.
Nadibhyam.
Nadibhyaha.
Nadibhyam. Nadibhyaha. Nadyaha.
Nadyaha.
Nadyoho.
Nadyoho.
Nadinam.
Nadinam.
Nadyam.
Nadyam.
Nadyoho.
Nadyoho.
Nadishu.
Nadishu.
He nadi.
He nadi.
He nadyau.
He nadyau.
He nadyaha.
He nadyaha.
No, nadi means river, right? So I'm going to point to some of these words now. Now, it would not be on the river, from the river, by the river, with the river, over the river, all kind of thing like that, right? To the river. So now you will tell me which form is that. You will translate now. It will be like that. The river, this will be the river. That is subject, isn't it? This will be? I'm not asking for object, I'm asking for to the river, on the river, off the river. To the river. Okay, this will be?
Rivers.
This will be?
In
or on?
Rivers.
Like shark lives in rivers. No, not shark. Shark lives or something. Fish. Like fish live in rivers. So that could be in rivers. Plural. Isn't it? Oh, this will be? Correct, correct. Hey, you two rivers, like Ganga Yamuna, like that. When they, huh? It comes. This will come in Shastras and all. You'll see these words. Hey, you two rivers. Okay. From the river. Yes. From the river. Good. Okay. By the river. Correct, correct. By the river. Huh? Or with the river. By the river or with the river. By the river, all of you know that. Huh? Johnny break a bottle. Yeah. Down by the river, down by the sea. Johnny break a bottle and said what? Me. And I told man, ma told pa, and Johnny, get it good. Okay. Okay. So, nadi.
Nadi.
Nadyau.
Nadyau.
Nadyaha.
Nadyaha.
Nadim.
Nadim.
Nadyau.
Nadyau.
Nadihi.
Nadihi.
Nadya.
Nadya.
Nadibhyam.
Nadibhyam.
Nadibhihi.
Nadibhihi.
Nadyai.
Nadyai.
Nadibhyam.
Nadibhyam.
Nadibhyaha.
Nadibhyaha.
Nadyaha.
Nadyaha.
Nadibhyam.
Nadibhyam.
Nadibhyaha.
Nadibhyaha.
Nadyaha.
Nadyaha.
Nadyoho.
Nadyoho.
Nadinam.
Nadinam.
Nadyam.
Nadyam.
Nadyoho.
Nadyoho.
Nadishu.
Nadishu.
He nadi.
He nadi.
He nadyau.
He nadyau.
He nadyaha.
He nadyaha.
Now let us take one of these now and we do. Right? We superimpose. Superimpose, you know? What? Which letter is this middle one here? What is it made up of? The and?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Now see here, which one easy for you? Nari, is it? Nari.
Nari.
Or Janani. Also, nice to see all words. How Janani, what do you know? Janani, so well, so much use also, Nari. Patni. Dharampatni. Everybody in Trinidad says Dharampatni? Dharam patni or whatever, patni. Nari, let's say. Now, it will be Nari.
Nari.
Like this, right? Like Nari. So it will be Nari. Nari.
Nari.
Nadyau.
Nadyau.
Naryaha.
Naryaha.
Naryau.
Naryau.
Naryaha.
Naryaha.
The ra will become half. Here the becomes half. Okay. Again, nari.
Nari.
Naryo.
Naryo.
Naryaha.
Naryaha.
Narim.
Narim.
Naryo.
Naryo.
Narihi.
Narihi.
Yes. Narya.
Narya.
Naribhyam.
Naribhyam.
Naribhi.
Naribhi.
Narye.
Narye.
Naribhyam.
Naribhyam.
Naribhyaha.
Naribhyaha.
Naryaha. Naribhyam.
Naribhyam.
Naribhyaha.
Naribhyaha.
Naryaha.
Naryaha.
Naryoho.
Naryoho.
Narinam.
Narinam.
Naryam.
Naryam.
Naryoho.
Naryoho.
Narishu.
Narishu.
Hey Nari.
Hey Nari.
So if you're calling out to some woman, so hey Nari. You can't say hey Nari. Hey Nari. Hey Nario.
Hey Nario.
Hey Nariaha.
Hey Nariaha.
So therefore, homework, you will have to do 1, 2. Right, this thing is very nice. You will have some, your hand will have to get some good exercise in, because you will have to. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. For homework. To from last week, you're supposed to give me 5. I forget, but not too, for too long. Yes?
Okay.
Number 5. Ragni. Say?
Ragni.
Not ni, eh? Not like ni. Ni.
Ni.
Ni.
Ni.
Like, so the letter will be nya. Say nya. Nya. Yeah. So that you have to add an E to that now. Nya.
Say?
Nya.
Nya.
Nya. Ni.
Ni.
Ragni.
Ragni.
Yes. Like that, right? So there's a queen. Ragni. Say ni. Okay. Now say these words after me then. Nagari.
Nagari.
Tatri.
Tatri.
Prithivi.
Prithivi.
Vani.
Vani.
Ragni.
Ragni.
Simhi.
Simhi.
Janani.
Janani.
Nari.
Nari.
Patni.
Patni.
Bhagini.
Bhagini.
See that, you direct like that. I told you, learn the Sanskrit well, you go read Ramayana like that. Tulsidas. Shur Panakar Ravan Kai Bhagini. Exact word. Pure Sanskrit. No change also. Shurpanaka, you see, starts like Shurpanaka, no introducing Ramayana. First line. Shurpanaka Ravan Kai Bhagini. Now, what do you say? Immediately you go understand the sentence. What is it? See, you don't have the book in front of you, and you, this is all the words I just tell you is in Sanskrit. Now, did you understand or not? Shur Panaka Ravan Kai Bhagini. The only Kai re. That Kai alone is not proper Sanskrit. All the rest of the word is? Sanskrit. Shur Panaka was there, Ravan sister. Bas. All this you don't know, yeah? All these words you will know. Prithivi, you know. Earth. Vani. Akash Vani. So, Bhagini.
Bhagini.
Grihini.
Grihini.
Grihini means housewife. This is a very well used word in Hindi and Tulsidas also uses. So, you just learn all of these words will appear. Every word. Let me see which word doesn't appear. This is the only word you will not see in Ramayana. This one. Every one of these words you will see in Ramayana. So now you say that's what if you learn Sanskrit, how Ramayana becomes? Because there's nobody who teaches Awadhi.
Awadhi is the language of Ramayana. Nobody teaches that. That language? Born. But there's no need to teach. You just learn your Sanskrit properly. You remember Samiji was talking about Sanskrit last night? Very, very important. People say, no, learn your Hindi, learn your Hindi. No. Sanskrit is a million times more important than Hindi. Hindi is okay because you could listen to Bollywood music and you could know what they're saying, you know. You could know what they're saying in the Bollywood song, you know. Savan ka mahina pavan kare shor.
sor. And she's saying short. Baba short nahi, sor, sor, sor. So you could understand a Hindi film song, but that I could do nothing for you again. That is after that done. And this you will get into all Puranas, Upanishad, everything. Atulsi Ramayan. People who speak Hindi in India, they don't understand Tulsi Ramayan. That's why under it, if you look under it, Chopa, you will see a Hindi translation. You look at that? They are translated to Hindi. Just by knowing Hindi, you can understand those. Chopai. That's why there's a Hindi translation underneath. But if you learn Sanskrit, you're good to go. Alright, so all the words are there. So that you have, you, today you have to give me 5, and you have, and the next day you have to do 5. Now, we have 2 more classes, Puja and Hindi. Today I want you to excuse me from those 2 classes. And we will pick it up. Now let me see how much time I have left. Maybe I can do a little. I'll do a little practice with you. Next week we'll have all of that because Amji is here and we have too many going on. And then we have a relationship of parents today and too many happening one time. But I like GZ. I don't like to be. I do not like to be. 20 years I've been doing it, so I am. I still stand in that. Yeah. This one, that kind of observe keeping.
All right. Sentence on the board. Now say it after me. Lakshmanaha
Lakshmanaha
Nadim
Nadim
Pashyati
Pashyati.
Right.
Now what case and number it looking like?
Masculine. Correct.
So that means that would be the set, the subject of the sentence, isn't it? I think that is singular. The verb also has to be in?
Singular.
So the verb there, Pashyati, say?
Pashyati.
What it looks like now? What number and person? Third person, singular. And the root for that is, I mean the meaning for that will be? Actually, Trish is the root for that. I don't think there's a button here. To see. Drish means to see. Right? So from that drish, this Pashyati comes. How it comes? Don't worry, don't too much yet. But it look, you know it's third person?
Singular.
So that means he, she, or it?
Sees.
So in this case, who is seeing?
Lakshmana
sees. Lakshmana sees. Now, the object of the sentence, he's seeing something. That thing got to be in second case, isn't it? So here, just now you, from your notes you will know, this is, say Nadim. So Lakshmana sees the
river.
Okay, like that. You hold on to this model. Hold on to this model. Get this model in your head. Get, shastras will become very easy. Don't lose track of this model. You look for a subject in first case. Now, once you have the model, like for example, what? In a human being, right? You have the skeleton. The skeleton have a skull, arms, legs, and all of the bones, right? Skeleton. Now, even though the skeleton in everybody's body have the same thing, like one, everybody have a skull, everybody have a hip bone and femurs and this and whatever. But on the outside now, you have a lot of variation. Some people mota, some people chota, some people, you know, all kind of different. Different, but
But the common thing will be there. Everybody have the same number of bones, and you know, same bones. But outside, now everybody turn out. But this is like a skeleton of Sanskrit. You hold on to that. Now you gonna make little variation here. Like I will turn into passive and make variation, but the skeleton will remain there. As you learn more Sanskrit and you become more advanced, you will learn to put the same. This is an active sentence. Lakshmana sees river. But the passive sentence for that would be the river is seen by Lakshmana. So you have to do a little bit of manipulation of those words and all. Because in Sanskrit this is very important. More than half the sentences in Sanskrit, more than half, will be in passive form, which is not there in English. It is totally unlike English in that regard. In English, we speak in active all the time. Right? So much so that a sentence that you cannot make in passive, in English, you could very well make it in Sanskrit. I'll give you an example. To go is an intransitive verb in English. So I go to Cuba. Right? You could make a sentence. I go to proper sentence in English?
Yeah.
Proper. In English, can you say Cuba is gone by me?
No.
That sounds very funny, isn't it? You can't say that in English. Cuba is gone by me. Because to go is an intransitive verb. It's not transitive. You can't switch it and make it into a passive sentence in English. But because the Sanskrit language has so many passive sentences, you could very well make that sentence in Sanskrit. You can't in English. You're dead wrong. So passive is very important in Sanskrit. And all it requires, you take this skeleton and you switch the flesh around a little bit. This skeleton and the language. So you just have to say, so it'll say the river is seen by Lakshmana. That will be the passive form. So you later on, when we get into those topics, you will learn how to do that. But here it's very much active now. Lakshmana sees the river. The other thing I told you, please remember those things. Any word here can come anywhere in that line, and it will not change that meaning because they have cases. So it doesn't matter where the word is, the case can't change, right? But in English, you can't do that. Impossible. See, I told you before. Can you switch the words in that sentence? Suppose you switch fox and dog. The meaning will be same. So appreciate the language like this now. See the difference? You can't switch any word here. You have to write it exactly as it is. Here you switch any word and put it wherever you want, and you're okay. Right. And you know, let me tell you something. Sometimes a word that is not there, the Rishi could just put our next word there. Chur. And that will symbolize something. Lakshmana sees the river and Lakshmana sees the river. So they're telling you something. That means he sees something else too. So they could put that there. So then you have to figure out why he put it. And beside the river, he sees something. Yeah, so now you do a little research to see what else he. And just nothing is wrong with the sentence. Now, if you put an X and in English, they will happen. Wrong. The teacher will give you wrong, isn't it? You see? But in Sanskrit, all of these things are possible. All right.
Is it possible to switch around
the nouns? Which way? Here. Switch the nouns. The river sees Lakshmana. Then you gotta change the cases. Yeah. Then Lakshmana will come in second case and river will come in first case. Right? I'm talking about switching the position of the words.
Like for example, and here you put. Now see, if you do that,
not a single thing changes in the sentence, eh? Nothing changes in that sentence. In fact, more often than not, you'll see it like this rather than that. More often you'll see it like this. These words will be everywhere. And you know how verses that have two lines?
Yeah.
You will find these two words in the first line and this last word in the next line. So you have to look for it. Sanskrit is constant research. You have to keep looking for it. So here, this is exactly this. All right. Okay, now next one. Rehat,
Nari,
Dhavati.
Dhavati.
Okay. Now this Dhavati word you have gotten from me before. I know. Now which is in first case now? You're looking for a subject, right? Which will be in first case? This is like Nari, Nadi. Just now we got only. So that means, now the Nari means woman. There's something about the woman. And this root, Dhavati, third person, singular. And Dhav means to run. Yes, Dhav means to run. So here's the sentence right there. Nari Dhavati. The woman
runs.
You have to, in English, you have to say runs. You know. Nari Dhavati, the woman runs. Now next word. What case it looks like? Fifth case.
Singular.
Correct. Aramat. Grihat. Halat. Right? Fifth case. So our fifth case is which preposition? From. From. So from the house, the woman runs. And in English, when you put that together, no? The woman runs from the house. The house maybe catch a fire? Maybe the house catch a fire or something and she run away. Like that. Get it? Now see, because it is in fifth case, no meaning could change. You have to keep the meaning right there. Eh? And you can switch around the words anywhere you like. Alright. You get that the hang of this whole thing now? Don't lose it. Keep that skeleton in your mind. Clear, clear, clear. And you know, if you go online, there are many, many. These days, people are uploading many, many wonderful things. You can do practices in all of this in Sanskrit. Get sentences and keep practicing. All right. So next week, when all of the busyness of the ashram gone, we'll resume. I'll give you sentences also with all of these new words which you got today. All right. Okay. I think now our time will be gone. And we will see in the new week. So no puja and mindi today. We'll resume that next week. All right. Om Purnamada
Purnamidam.